Tri-State Indie Live. Adam here with Matt Duke, a fellow Pennsylvanian, down here in Austin, Texas, for South by Southwest. How you doing, Matt?
I'm doing well, thanks.
So, how was your trip down here? This is your third time at South by, you said? Or first time performing, but you've been in Austin before, right?
I've been in Austin before, yeah.
So, what kind of expectations do you have for the festival?
A lot of people, hot weather, and a lot of music. That's pretty much it. My expectations have been met tenfold, which has been nice.
And you've only been here, what, like 4 hours?
If that, yeah. So I'm already exhausted.
So where's your show tonight?
Show tonight is at the Tap Room at Six Lounge, starting at 8. And I'm playing with a bunch of cool guys and some dudes that I've been on the road with before, like Tony Luca and this guy Jay Nash. And I think Andrew Bell is on the bill, too. So it should be a good night.
Are you trying to see any other bands after you're finished playing? Or?
I wish I could. I mean, we'll be going... I've got my set earlier in the night, like around 9, and then the other two guys that I mentioned, Tony and Jay, we all joined together and did some songwriting, and we're going to release a record sometime in the summer. So we'll have our three trio set around like 1 o'clock, and we're not going to be done until probably after 2. So I don't know if I'll get a chance to really see much of anything, but I'm kind of bummed because I think Omar Rodriguez is supposed to be here from Mars Volta. He's supposed to have a show, which I wish that I could catch, but... I'll try to do what I can.
Yeah. So are Tony and Jay from Philadelphia as well?
No, Tony's actually from L.A., and Jay lives in Vermont by way of Los Angeles. He just moved out that way. And we did a tour last year together. We got along well, put out an EP that did very well. And we did a tour this last winter, and that was the last time that I was in Austin. And we recorded in Chicago, which was fun.
So is that like another, is that a side project of yours, or is that something that's becoming like a full-time gig, playing with Tony and Jay?
It's definitely a side project, and we didn't intend for it to really be anything. When we first started playing, what was it, last year or the year before that, we just were jamming on each other's tunes. We get along really, really well. We have a lot of fun. We hang out together. But then we actually took the time to write this last tour, and... we'll just, in whatever time we're not touring and doing our solo thing, we'll try to all, you know, make it work that we can make our schedules work out, that we all get together and do a little touring here and there, which will be fun.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Do you have a name for the band?
The name was always tentatively TFDI, which was the first time we went out. It was Jay's motto for all things mundane. Like if you had to get in a van and do an 8-hour drive, he had like a song. And the main chorus was that we're totally fucking doing it. And that was our big, like our mantra.
It's fitting.
Our mantra to get through like really long hauls. And so that became the working title for the EP, and it stuck. So when we did the last tour, that was the name of the tour, which was cool.
So where would you place Philadelphia as far as like music towns? Like we have Austin, we have New York, LA obviously.
Yeah.
Where would you place that in the country?
I think over the last couple years, it's become quite the haven for singer-songwriters more than anything else. And a lot of that has to do with the local radio station WXPN, which is out of Penn, and they were huge into promoting local artists. And Amos Lee is obviously a guy who came from Philly, and he's doing very, very well. And we've got a whole bunch of guys who are from that area. But passing through, it's a very low-key kind of version of New York City in a lot of ways, and a lot more manageable. But outside of that, it's just like the scene is great. I mean, the World Cafe is awesome. Tin Angel, they've got what used to be JC Dobbs is now the Legendary Dobbs. We've got like the TLA and the Electric Factory, and it's, for whatever reason, I don't think a lot of people consider it to be one of the hotter spots, but everybody passes through it because it's such a great place, and all the venues more or less are listening venues regardless of what type of music it is. So it's a passionate music city.
Yeah, you definitely see it up and coming in the last few years, and I think one day Philadelphia will be, you know, top three.
Oh, it's already yeah. Top notch. It's awesome. Yeah, I'm glad. I'm very, very proud of the fact that I grew up around that area, which is cool.
So what's up for the rest of 2011 for you?
Well, the new record is going to be released in just a couple weeks, and once that comes out, I will be doing some one-offs here and there, but touring in June. and then going back out with Tony and Jay later in the summertime, and then a full-fledged tour in the fall. And that is about the extent of it. And making, I'm looking forward to in the next couple of weeks, I came up with a concept for these two music videos that we're gonna flesh out and actually do within the next month, which will be fun too, so.
So they'll get posted on your website?
Mm-hmm. Yep, website is mattdukemusic.net. Yeah.
Thanks a lot, Matt.
Thank you very much for having me and doing this.
Of course, have a good show tonight, and we'll catch you in Philly sometime.
Right on.
This is Tri-State Indie Live at South by Southwest with Matt Duke, TFDI, over and out.